Okay, we're up to Parsha Shoftim. We're back, Lakewood, New Jersey. Actually, this time, I actually felt that we're not going to have to come back from Eretz Yisrael. I don't know, I thought after being able to give a couple of shiurim from Eretz Yisrael, this time I thought really for sure that everybody's going to come join us there, but unfortunately it didn't happen. And we're hoping that we'll all be able to go back there soon together. This week's Parsha, aside from being this week's Parsha again, we're now into Chodesh Elul. So we're going to give a little mix. Parsha Shoftim, we'll mix in a couple of ideas for Elul, for Rosh Hashanah. The Pasuk says in this week's Parsha, Soim Tosim Alecha Melech. It's talking about the Parsha of making a Melech, making a king. Rak, what should you be aware of? What should a Melech be aware of? Layarba Loisusim. A Melech should not have too many, he shouldn't have too many horses. Layarba Loinoshim, he should have too many wives. The Kesset Lezog, Layarba Loimoid, he should have, be busy with accumulating material money, things like that. Then the Pasuk says, V'hayas HaShifte, HaKisim HaKisim HaKosa V'loi, that he should write as Mishneh HaTorah HaZois. That's the Pasuk. Again, to become a king shouldn't be busy with all these other things, accumulating wealth and all of that, and again, he should have a Chosav of as Mishneh HaTorah HaZois. The Gemara in Sanhedrin, Daf Chof Aleph Amit Beis, says that this Lashon of Mishneh HaTorah, we're all familiar with the Lashon of Mishneh HaTorah, this Lashon of Mishneh HaTorah is referring to that the Melech is supposed to have two separate Sifri Torah. So Melech is supposed to have Mishneh Torah, two separate Sifri Torah. One Sefer Torah is Beveis Kinaza, that stays in storage at the palace, so to speak. He keeps one Sefer Torah, Beveis Kinaza, he has it put away by him. And the other Sefer Torah, the other one, goes out with the Melech wherever he goes. The Melech goes out to war, the Melech goes out here, the Melech goes out there. Wherever he goes out, that second Sefer Torah goes with the Melech. So, the Nesiv HaShalom says, like we've said many times, and we've said it over in the Nesiv HaShalom, this is the Mahalach and the Nesiv HaShalom and everything, a person might ask, what exactly does this Parsha have to do with us now? What does it have to do with us? What do we learn from this week's Parsha? The Nesiv HaShalom says, as we've said many times, that this Parsha of the Torah, as in every other part of the Torah, is mitzvahs. This Parsha is nageya to us today, just as it would be again years ago, just in a different oifen. What is the nitzchias? The nitzchias is that this parsha is referring to, again, how a king is supposed to act. And man malchi, who are the kings? Who are the kings today? Rabbonan, b'nei Torah, people that consider themselves b'nei Torah, people that consider themselves Rabbonan, they have to abide by what we just said. So notice, the Torah first tells us at the beginning of the Pasuk, the Sur Meirah. The Torah tells us first, how's a Talmud Chacham, how's a Ben Torah supposed to act? Lo Yarbe Lo Susim. He's not supposed to be worried about, don't put your betochen in Gashmias. He's not supposed to be worried about how he's going to make more money, put away wealth. That's not what a Ben Torah is supposed to be busy with. He's supposed to trust in Hashem, and that's what his betochen is. Then we say also at the beginning of the pasuk, the Sur Meirah, Loyarbeloy Noshim, that he shouldn't be busy with his taivas. A Ben Torah shouldn't be busy with taivas. So then after that, once we finish with that, now how's it again to us? Also, the pasuk goes ahead and says the Asay Toiv part. The pasuk goes ahead and says, once we did the Sur Meirah, once you know that you have to do all those things, that you don't go after the taivas, you don't go put your betochen in money and all those things, the Torah tells you the Asay Toiv. What is the Asay Toiv? The Asay Toiv is that now you have to take the Sefer Torah with you. The Sefer Torah has to be two different types of Sefer Torah, like we said. What are they? The first one, the first Sefer Torah, the Asay Toiv, the part of the pasuk that talks about taking the Torah with you. First Sefer Torah is one that we said today, the Beis Genaza. And this, Zav Nesiv HaShalom is talking about, like the Ramah says, beginning of Shulchan Aruch, a person has to always be aware that even when you're alone in your house, and even when you're somewhere where you think that you're not being seen, and you think that you're hidden, Rama says the fundamental thing that he has to know, and it's good to know in Elul also, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is watching every single thing we do. And that, what the Torah is alluding to when it says about the Sefer Torah, Beveis Kenozov, a person has to understand that there's HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that Beveis Kenozov, when you think you're hidden away, when you think you're away, and a person has to understand Maloi Chal Haaretz Kulay, that wherever you go, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is here, that a person cannot hide. That's Beveis Kenozov. The second Sefer Torah, it tells you how a Talmud Chacham is supposed to act when he's out in public. A Talmud Chacham has to have a certain type of behavior, like the Rambam, famous Rambam, many B'nai Torah know, or they should know, the Rambam in Hilchos Deis talks about, it says that a Talmud Chacham has a special way, a Yid doesn't eat like everybody else, a Yid doesn't drink like everybody else, a Yid doesn't talk or act like everybody else. And in any circumstance, that alludes to the Sefer Torah that the Melech takes with him when he goes out in the street. When you go out in the street, you always have to remember also, just like we said, the Beis Kenozov, here when you go out in the street, you always have to know today that there's a Sefer Torah with you. And that's the lesson of the Parsha. That's the Nitzdias of this week's Parsha, that the same halachas that apply to a Melech who is a king of a country, a Melech who was a king then of Klal Yisrael, and someone who was a Melech, Man Malchi, who are the Malachim today? Rabbanan, the Talmidei Chacham, they have to abide by these same rules where they have a Sefer Torah. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is with you in the Chadri Chadarim, in your house, and also HaKadosh Baruch Hu is with you when you go out. You have to always create a Kiddush Hashem, be on a higher level than anyone else when you go out also. The pasuk continues. In that same parsha, the pasuk says, "V'karuboy kol yimei chayav," that the melech has to read from this Sefer Torah all the days of his life. So the Sefer Shalom brings down from the Tiferes Shleim an unbelievable shot here. The Gemara says in the Sefer Brachos, Daf Hei Oman Aleph, like this, famous Gemara also. I know we always say every Gemara is famous, but Baruch Hashem, and people nod their heads over here, so we see that most of the Gemaras are famous. In Roya Adam, if a person sees Sheyisurim Boin Alav, a person sees that unfortunately he has troubles in his life, he has Yisurim, what do? Yifash Beish B'masa. A person should make a Cheshben HaNefesh, he should check into his Maisim, check into his things that he does. Well, does up to Gemara, but Pish Peish B'lay Matza. Let's say a person, he looks and he goes through his Maisim and he doesn't find anything. Zabti Gemara, Yitle Bevitul Torah. A person, if you can't find anything that you may have done wrong, and you have Yisur in your life, there has to be a reason. So Zabti Gemara, be Torah it in Bitul Torah. And everybody asks the Kasha, there's an obvious bomb Kasha over here. Isn't Bitul Torah Chet? We said a person should go through everything that he does, and if he doesn't find something, then be Torah in Bitul Torah. But Bitul Torah is also something. And Bitul Torah is also Chet. If you're trying to go through your Chatoim, you should come up with Bitul Torah in the first time around. Zuck Nasiva Shalman, unbelievable, very interesting parents. What gives a person the ability to know that he's doing something wrong? Now we're coming in Elul, a person has to make a cheshbon hanefesh. What gives a person the ability to know? The Yetzer Hara, actually, what does the Yetzer Hara want? The Yetzer Hara wants a person to be totally blind from anything that he's doing wrong. The Yetzer Hara wants you to do an Avera, he wants you to do a Chet, and at the same time, he wants you to think you're doing nothing wrong, because that's how he gets you to do another Avera, and one Avera leads to another Avera. So he doesn't want you to understand, or to believe, or to think that you're doing something wrong. So, how does a person know that he's doing something wrong? Zokin Nesiva Shalom, that is through Koyach HaTorah. But Ho'er Einenu B'Sarah Sechel. We ask the Rabbanu Shalom to open our eyes by learning the Torah, but Ho'er Einenu B'Sarah Sechel. We should be able to understand and see our actions, see and to understand and to know when we do something wrong. The Torah enlightens us. And that is what the Gemara means, Zokin Nesiva Shalom. Pishpesh Feloi Matzah. If a person looks through his Maisim, goes through his day, goes through his week, goes through his past year, and wants to know why he has Yisurim, why life isn't so good, Pishpesh Balay Matzah, Yitle Bebitul Torah, up in the Shiva Shalom, it means that when you're searching for something, and you don't come up with something, Yitle Bebitul Torah, the reason you don't see what you're doing, the reason you can't make an honest accounting of what's going on in your life, is because means that if you can't come up with anything, everybody has something that they did wrong. Everybody has something, if they're honest with themselves, something they can fix up. You can't find anything. Yitle b'bitul Torah, it's a sign that you are not, it's a sign that you're being mevatel Torah, that you're not learning the Torah. And not necessarily, Zachman Steve Shalom, not necessarily that you were not learning Torah at all. Most of us do learn Torah. But what kind of Torah, how are you learning the Torah? Are you learning the Torah while you're checking your text messages? Are you being mevatel a Seder for a reason? Maybe that's not so good. That's also called Bittul Torah. Bittul Torah doesn't just mean what we think of the big Aver Bittul Torah. Bittul Torah means if Torah is not being learned as it should be learned, you're not putting the proper effort, you're not giving it your all, you're not giving it as much time as you can. And that's the Bittul Torah. And once a person does learn the Torah, we get the opportunity to realize that we're doing something wrong. And that's the koyach, we said, of Man Malchi Rabbona, the Koraboy Koyimei Chayav, that you're able to have the koyach throughout your life, when you read the Torah, to know which direction your life is going. You're able to understand from the Torah that you're doing something wrong. And the truth of the matter is, this is a very good Eitzah and a very big Eitzah as we're going through Elul and we're coming up to Rosh Hashanah and everything. It's interesting. Everybody always looks, you look for a skula, you look for a schus, you look for something to Elul, something before Rosh Hashanah to do. Happens to be the Chafetz Chaim also says, I think it's coming up also in the lessons of the during Elul also. He says that he sees a lot of people that it comes before Yom Narayim, it comes, people look for schools for Parnassa all the time, and they go to this thing and you try to do this school and that school. In the meantime, the biggest schools are right here, the things that are a person. It tells you right away the schools, the things that are. Proven, Baruch Menusa, that do things for us are right here in front of you. And one of these things, and Siva Shalom says here, is also, it's a very nice thing, and everything has a place in someone's life, to look for a skula, to go here, to go to this place in Eretz Yisrael, and circle the Kevin 7 times, and drink 8 bottles of whatever while you're doing it. Everything has a place, and everything has its reason, but the push of the things that a person has to know, Yiklev Bebitul Torah, a person has to look, What kind of madrega he is in Torah. And we should taka be zoicha, that when we do learn the Torah, that we should taka be able to understand and come to the table with what an Elul is and what a Rosh Hashanah is. And that's how we have a higher inenu b'sara zecha. By learning the Torah, we'll be able to understand what we have to do in Elul, how do we have to prepare for Rosh Hashanah. And that's learned from the pasuk in this week's parsha, the nitzchis in this week's parsha, of how a melech is supposed to behave. That's the Man Malki Rabbanan, that the Bnei Torah are supposed to take these lessons from a melech, and that's what Bnei Torah have to do, and take these lessons to heart, and then understand that we are the melachim of today.